Hello nature lovers, thanks for joining me today. You'll have noticed that the title of this video is Access Denied. The reason being that my local suburban lake, or rather urban lake really, has been cordoned off. There's no public access to it at all at the moment, and it's been like that for a couple of months. We've got these, as you'll see here, we've got these massive pink hoarding boards all around it. Why they chose this leery pink, God only knows. But no, you can't get to the lake except for the bridge that runs across it near the western end. And even that has got some high metal fencing along each side, with mostly some green netting as well, so you can't even get much of a view along the lake from the bridge, except sometimes people tear bits of the netting aside so they can see along the lake. And fortunately that was the case when I went a few weeks ago and took this rather nice photo of a kingfisher. Apart from that, there's no access to the lake at all, and it's all to do with some building works that are going on to the east of the lake, where they're building some new homes along the southern edge of Mark's Gate Estate, between the existing homes and the dual carriageway A12 Eastern Avenue. But anyway, so for my local wildlife fix, I thought I would try an alternative venue. So again, I jumped on my little folding bike, which you'll have seen in some of my other videos, and I headed down to Goodmayes Park, which sits a few miles to the east of Ilford, and I accessed it from Green Lane. And in that park there is a lake, which I should think it's probably at least double the area of Padnell Lake. It's certainly about 30% longer and probably about 150% wider on average. So let's have a look and see what I managed to film down at Goodmayes Park Lake. And I'll join you again at the end. Although somewhat larger than Padnell Lake, this one does share some similarities. A bridge about two-thirds of the way along, and an island near one end. I'm at the northern end here, which seems popular with the local black-headed gulls. At first I thought they were the only gull species here, but there is at least one common gull, just there, front and centre. Ah, there it goes. The black-headed gull is our commonest inland gull, and despite its name, even in its adult breeding plumage, the head is more of a dark chocolate brown than black. The rest of the year, the head just has some dark smudges behind and above the eyes. It's easy to get complacent and dismissive of common birds, but watching their behaviour can nevertheless be both interesting and entertaining. Here's some interesting feeding behaviour. This gull is a first winter youngster. You can tell by the remnants of scaly brown plumage in the wings. Another youngster flies in and harries the first one away. It seems this bit of the lake is quite desirable. Further down the lake, past the bridge, I spot this quintet on a low wall. We can see again that the one on the right-hand end is a juvenile, not just by the wings, but also by the legs and bill colour. Right, that's enough of gulls. Let's see what else is about on and around this lake. Ah, here are two common members of the rail family, moorhen and coot. People sometimes get confused as to which is which. An easy way to remember is to think of the expression bald as a coot, which is referencing the white bald patch above the coot's white bill. The moorhen, on the other hand, has a red bill with a yellow tip and a rather distinctive white staggered line down its side, which is also present on the brown juveniles. Having relocated to the southern end of the lake, My first bird encounter was a feral pigeon. I saw some earlier on by the Gull Quintet. They're descended from the wild rock dove, which inhabits the rocky coasts of western Scotland. Next, it was the ubiquitous Canada goose. As their name suggests, not strictly a native species. As far as I could discover, it seems they did naturally reach Europe, but they were also introduced in the 17th century. For an urban lake, this gaggle of greylag geese was no great surprise, but what did surprise me was that I only saw one mallard. And even so, this drake did not look like a purebred example by any means, and seemed to be under the impression that it's a Canada goose, as it was very firmly attached to this particular pair. Oh well, takes all sorts, I suppose. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. Pretty much the usual suspects as far as urban waterfowl is concerned, with I'm surprised there aren't more mallard there, to be fair, and even the one that was there is having an identity crisis, thinks it's a Canada goose by the look of it. But yeah, hope you enjoyed that. I've got to be heading off right now. I'm a busy person. If it's not work, it's other things. I've got to go and help my local church with their live stream to Facebook this morning, so I'd better get cracking. Join me again soon on Naturally Curious UK. Meanwhile, stay safe, stay sane, stay curious, and keep enjoying the wonders of nature where you are.